Welcome all participants to this session on orientation to the B.Ed. admission process. In just a minute, I'll tell you about my college. Okay, I think most of you know me. I'm Dr. Vaishali Savant, Associate Professor at Hansraj Jivandas College of Education. And I've been dealing with admissions since last 22 years. Hansraj Jivandas College of Education was established in the year 1969, and we have already completed our 50 years in the field of education and offering the B.Ed. course. It's a government-aided Gujarati linguistic minority institution and has been given the A-plus grade by NAC in the third cycle. The first B.Ed. college in Maharashtra to receive the RUSA grant. I would say the first B.Ed. college where digital launch of RUSA projects was done by our Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji. Our college has been recognized under 2F and 12B by UGC. That's a small part about our college. Many more things, you can go on our college website and you'll get to know many, many more things about the college. Okay, now this is our trend, you know, like we do this. This is not a new trend, I would say. We've been doing it since last 10 years or so. We have been conducting orientations. This time we are, since I think last year, we are doing series of sessions, you can call them workshops, with respect to the complete B.Ed. admissions, about the exams, the CET exams, the ELCT exams. In the CET exam, you have mental ability, you have teacher aptitude. So we would be conducting separate sessions for those. Today is the first session where I'll give you a complete overview. Okay, about the B.Ed. admission process, the exams, what type of questions are asked, how is the merit list prepared, how does the admission process take place, all that. And after that, I'm going to keep, you can have say like maybe half an hour or 1 hour for the queries, individual queries you have. For that, I'm going to keep some time. Okay. We also have a WhatsApp group. We have rather two groups because one group was full. So we had to begin another group. And any queries which you feel you wanted to ask, but because of less time you could not ask, you can ask on the WhatsApp group also. Okay, we all are, there are other students also, there are other candidates also who are very active and they put up all updates, everything about the B.Ed. admission process is seen on the WhatsApp group. I would request all the participants to keep a pen or a pencil and paper with you because we would be actually solving some questions, some problems which are asked, you know, similar kind are asked in the CET exam, ELCT exam. So please, a request to keep a pen and a paper or a pencil and a paper with you so that you can quickly solve it there also. And another thing, please rename yourself. I can see some of you are galaxies and some of you are E1M. So please rename yourselves with your proper names because I may call you out. How do I call you out? Okay. If you have a query or something, I will call out your names. Okay. So request. So with this, should we begin with the B.Ed. admission process? Yes, your pen paper ready. Please give me a thumbs up. Okay, good, great. Okay, excellent. Oh, all set, all ready. I can see so many of you so enthusiastic about the B.Ed. admission process. Okay, so let us begin. Okay, Mr. Rakesh Pawar. Yes, you have raised your hand. Is there something that you want to know right at the beginning? Mr. Rakesh Pawar? No. I think by mistake you have raised your hand. Okay. So the orientation to B.Ed. admission process, we begin with the session. said, be alert, be ready, and think of whatever questions you have. You may keep your questions ready, but I'll take them at the end only. Okay, you can put the questions in the chat box also if you have mic issues and all that. Okay, I have got three people, and these three people represent you. The students, or you can say these candidates, represent you. So this is a girl. This is a TY student, Binaisha, and she's aspiring to become a secondary school teacher. Of course, she needs to be a graduate, or maybe in the last year, and you know, waiting for her results or so. And she needs to have 50% of marks for BCom, BA, and BSc courses, and 55% marks for management, BAF, sociology. Somebody has done social sciences, sociology, BDS, or engineering, or let's say BAF, BMM. For that, you need 55% marks. So Binaisha needs to have this marks here. Some good communication skills. The remaining we will take care of. Likes to be with children. Some clarity in thought and expression. Others we will take care of. Should have good knowledge of her subject, which she is planning to take for, you know, at the B.Ed. level, so that she can teach the same subject at the school or junior college level. She should, she should like to take part in or organize co-curricular activities also. Now, if Binaisha wants to join the state board, ICSC board, CBSC board, Binaisha needs to be a graduate with 50-55% of marks and a B.Ed. degree. Okay. And if Binaisha wants to join any IGCSC board or IB board, these boards also prefer B.Ed. degree. Of course, after that, once you join school, you may do the Cambridge International Diploma in Teaching Learning. But this IGCSE board and IB boards, nowadays there are many such boards coming up, and many of you are interested in joining these boards. So B.Ed. is the basic degree. If you go there without a B.Ed. degree, thinking that you will do CIDTL or you will join an IB board and do the courses, those schools would not give you a pay package at par with someone who has done B.Ed. So remember this. We have many of our students teaching at IB and IGCSE board, and they have told us that we don't, without a B.Ed. degree, we do not get the same pay package, you know, at par with those who have done a B.Ed. degree. So it's always better, always do your B.Ed. degree. Okay, but for some courses like French and all, they may take you without a B.Ed. degree. Otherwise, B.Ed. degree is a must. IB board, B.Ed. degree, and ongoing, they have their ongoing courses. Okay, now Binaisha, if she's planning to join some state board, and you know, she better that she clears the TET. So TET exam is based on the B.Ed. syllabus only, not compulsory for nowadays in private schools, but maybe they make it compulsory later. So that many of our students, while doing B.Ed., because of the quality that we offer in our B.Ed. program, they have cleared their central teacher eligibility test and the TET exams while they were doing B.Ed. Okay, so it is based on the B.Ed. syllabus. So attending those B.Ed. Lectures, attending or understanding all the ideas, the syllabus properly, going in depth of it, it is possible to clear the TET exams, CTET and TET exams also. Now this is Kavita, again a TY student, and she is aspiring to join a higher secondary or becoming a junior college teacher. Again, she needs to be a postgraduate. Of course, at graduation, 50-55% marks, and post-graduation, again, 50% marks. Good communication skills, likes to be with youth, clarity in thought and expression, has very good knowledge of her subject. and likes to take part or organize co-curricular activities. So what Binaisha can do, again, she needs to be a postgraduate with a B.Ed. degree to join as a junior college or a higher secondary level teacher. In IGCSE board, again, B.Ed. is preferred. You all can also do the CIDTL program, which the school offers. And in IB board, again, B.Ed. is only preferred. Of course, they have their ongoing programs once you join IB board schools. Now, there are some of you who are interested in doing B.Ed. special. Any idea what is B.Ed. special? One of you can just unmute. What is B.Ed. special?
Yes, ma'am. It is for special child.
Yes. Very good. Okay. I'm so happy that you are alert and active and listening. Okay. It is to teach children who are differently abled. And for that, you need to do your B.Ed. special. Okay. It's called as B.Ed. special. And B.Ed. regular is the normal course. You can join the other, schools where you have all kinds of children coming, whereas B.Ed. special is where differently abled children are taught. So if you're interested, like Bijoy, in becoming a special education teacher in a school, you will have to do B.Ed. special. Now, where is that B.Ed. special course? While you click on that B.Ed. CET, ELCT link, in that only they will ask you, are you interested in B.Ed. special? So you have to click B.Ed. special there, and then you will be considered for the B.Ed. special course. So you have to be very clear as to you want to do B.Ed. special or you want to do your regular B.Ed. Please be clear about it. Okay, you cannot say that I'll try this also, I'll try that also. Be very clear. Accordingly, you will have to click the link for B.Ed. special. Okay, with the B.Ed. degree, with the B.Ed. special degree and graduation, students like Bijoy can join special schools, can begin their private coaching, and can teach for all boards and can help all boards. Now, there were many questions by you that, madam, what is going to happen to this B.Ed. 2 years course? Is there any 1 year course? What about the 4 years integrated course? Okay, let us clear this confusion. Till 2030, the 2 years B.Ed. degree after graduation will exist. It will be there. Okay. After that, after 2030, like let's say from 2030, they are planning to make 4 years integrated B.Ed. degree, which would be B.A. B.Ed., B.Sc. B.Ed. or B.Com. B.Ed. in a multidisciplinary setup, like how you have your regular colleges, after 12th standard. So I believe that all of you who have come to attend this session are graduates. And you're not interested, you're not looking out for the 4 year integrated B.Ed. degree for which the link was open and the admission process has begun for that. Okay. Now, admission to both this B.Ed. 4 year integrated, which is going to begin in Mumbai University most probably next year after 12, not after graduation. So after graduation, no one would be interested in doing a B.A. B.Ed. or B.Sc. B.Ed. Okay, so for now, till 2030, you can do your 2 years B.Ed. degree after graduation. But somebody is interested after 12, so they can. Right now, if you check, there are only some colleges, 1-3 colleges in Kolhapur University right now offering this 4 year integrated B.Ed. degree. And in this WhatsApp group and in this session, I am guiding only for B.Ed. 2 years. And remember, this entire admission process is conducted through the Common Entrance Test, okay? The CET cell of state government, okay? The Maharashtra government looks after this entire admission process, just like your MHCET engineering exams and all that. your law, MEd. So just like that, the admission process to BEd course is managed by the CET cell, state government. Okay. So college does not do any admissions on its own. The entire admission process is done by the common entrance, the CET cell of the state government. Only at the end, when there are vacant seats and all, and the spot round, maybe the fourth round or so, that time you can approach the college directly, but that too the college will admit you on the merit basis only. Okay, so please, you can just approach the college to find out, but the admissions are done by the state government only, by the CET cell, which will give you a letter of admission which carries weightage. No college can give you any letter of admission. Remember this. Am I clear, all of you? No college, any college tells you, we will do your admissions directly. There are things, but that college will also, okay, if some college is running after you to come and take admission in their college, please check their credibility. Please check what is their value in the market. Okay, don't run. Why will colleges run after you? Colleges have just 50 seats. A few colleges have 100. So 50 seats, why will colleges run after you? Think about it. Okay. There was some confusion that 1 year BEd course will be restarted. No 1 year BEd course is going to be restarted. No one is going to start. Okay. So we are going to have this 2 years BEd program. Something was in mind that after your post graduation, you can do 1 year BEd. Something was there, but nothing is going to be. The focus is on 2 years BEd and the 4 years BEd. Okay. And maybe, after they implement the 4 years graduation course, after the national, as per the National Education Policy 2020, maybe after that, they may plan a 1 year BEd course. That is in pipeline. Okay. Remember, 2 years BEd will not exist after 2030. So till 2030, so 10 years from now, 9 years from now, we would have this 2 years BEd program. But from 2030, 4 years integrated BEd would be the basic qualification for teaching. Okay, am I clear till here? I'll take a 1 minute break. Any doubts, anything you want to ask, please ask.
Ma'am, I wanted to know, are you going to talk about the BEd and MEd integrated course that
no,
is there?
No. It's only okay. BEd 2 years that I'm going to talk about. But BEd MEd integrated also, the admissions are through CET exams only.
Okay. And ma'am, I just wanted to know for that, can I do it after my master's or should I only after BEd is when I can do the integrated course? Like how does that work? If you can just throw some light on it.
BEd MEd is after graduation or post graduation. So you do your post graduation MA, MSc, MCom. After that, okay, or after BA, BSc, BCom, you can do your BEd MEd 3 years integrated. If you're sure that you want to do MEd also, so you may go for the 3 years integrated program.
Okay.
Maybe this have started. So you may check out that. But I am orienting only for 2 years BEd program. That is what we have in our college.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much.
Most of the colleges have the 2 years BEd program. So you have to plan beforehand. You can try giving both BEd and MEd integrated also. You may try giving BEd also. So whatever is your plan, you can think beforehand and go accordingly.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Any more doubts before I proceed further? I'll be yes.
Ma'am, I have one doubt. Ma'am, I just wanted to ask that I have done my graduation in BMM, but now I don't plan to continue in that field. So which 2 year program will I be looking for? Because they have programs for separately, or do they have it for specific open for BM?
You will be doing in BEd, no? You will be doing a BEd degree. Nowadays, even ISC schools have this mass media course and all for their 11th, 12th. So they even look out for somebody who's done MMM and a B.Ed degree. So those people also get jobs. You can do your B.Ed now, and if you're planning further, you can do a post-graduation in your mass media. So right now, if you feel better get into B.Ed, you can try getting into B.Ed.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Any more queries? Should I proceed further?
Ma'am, can we do M.Com and B.Ed at the same time?
I'll talk about this a little later. You'll have to wait for this.
Ma'am, good morning. I have a question, ma'am. As you gave the examples of those students, so keeping that, if a teacher wants to teach in pre-primary section of an international or a state board school or in first or second grade of a primary section, will B.Ed be helpful?
Many private schools, they take B.Ed. Many of our students, you know, they have joined primary sections. Okay, freshers and all, they at times, they have joined the primary section. But if you're planning to go right at the pre-primary level, and now with the national education policy coming up, and you're interested in doing only that pre-primary, the foundational course, those 5 years preparatory course and all that, so please go for ECCED. Okay. And the government is planning to, NCERT is planning to devise a complete course for this ECCED. They're going to give a lot of focus on ECCED also. And for ECCED, you can approach colleges directly where the program is there. But even private schools take people with B.Ed.
So ma'am, I have done my ECCE. And what if I want to teach in primary, now if I want to go a little bit high, if I want to teach in primary section, say grade 1, grade 2, then B.Ed will add on my qualification.
Yes. Many of our students we have, they have done ECCED and they have come to do B.Ed also.
Okay.
Is that fine?
Good morning, ma'am. Yes. I have one query. This is Bhavna Joshi. I have done my graduation 15 years back. And I've done the graduation from MP. So what the actual...
I'll talk about it later. During the course, please attend the session. Okay? Yeah. Everything I'm going to talk about in the session.
Okay ma'am. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Quick overview of the 2 years B.Ed program. We call it 2 years B.Ed program. And the link is also, I'll be posting a video as to how you can fill up the form about... Be very clear. You want to do 2 years B.Ed course? The last link is about B.Ed, CET and ELCT. Maharashtra, B.Ed, CET and ELCT. It has happened in the past. Students have clicked anywhere. B.Ed, M.Ed integrated, 4 years integrated. Please don't do that. Be very clear. Okay. There are 4 semesters. Okay. It's a 2 years program. Usually, it actually does not take complete 2 years. It would take 1 year and some 6, 7, 8 months. But it's a 2 years program having full-time 2 years program. I'm repeating and I'm reiterating that it's a full-time 2 years program. So if any college is telling you it's a part-time course or correspondence course, aisa kuch nahi hai. It's a proper full-time course. And if you have not attended, and the university finds this out, that you have not attended college, you have not done this much attendance, anyone can take objection to your degree. Okay? So people, colleges are cheating you if they're telling you need not attend. It's a full-time course. 80 and 90% attendance for your internship programs and 80% attendance for theory is important. And colleges with properly qualified teachers. Okay, those colleges offer the proper full-time 2 years course. It only if you are already teaching somewhere for last 2 years, you can do your B.Ed from IGNU or YCMOU. Okay, and there also they have 1 month residential program. Otherwise, they do it in a correspondence mode. Remember, no college under Mumbai University can give any correspondence or part-time course. B.Ed is full-time only. Okay, I've made this clear again and again. People keep asking that can I do correspondence IGNU or YCMU? Not at all under Mumbai University. Okay, so remember if the college tells you need not attend, that means this is all you can understand. You are all matured people here. Okay, so you have to attend 4 semesters of the full-time 2-year program. you have to complete practicum, internal assessment, assignments, you know, all that, which is a part of internal assessment for each theory paper. Now, in the first semester, as you can see, there is you need to do community work. You need to take participate in co-curricular activities. See, this is a complete training for a becoming a teacher. And in national education policy, the focus is on proper getting properly trained. B.Ed, there is lots to learn in B.Ed, which you have not learned up till graduation. There's lots to learn in B.Ed. Okay? So please look at it very positively that you want to learn, because what you would be learning, you would be implementing in schools. And NEP is focusing on quality teachers. Okay? Remember, you have to participate in co-curricular activities. There are three papers or courses in every semester. And for every course, you have to write assignments, give class tests, essays. There's a detailed documentation on ICT in education, community work, I have repeated. Second semester, there is an internship of 3 weeks. Like colleges like us, nowadays we do online internship. Our students are going in online classes of schools and they are shadowing teachers, they are observing their lessons, okay? And they have to give 5 lessons in schools. They have to participate in co-curricular activities, again, 3 courses, assignments, class test, essays, okay? There's a content test for the subject that you have selected for teaching. Third semester, there is an internship for 11 weeks. 10 lessons, the lessons that you've taken as your first subject for teaching, like English, science, maths, geography, history. 10 lessons plus 5 lessons are those special lessons, theme-based and co-teaching lessons. You have to prepare and administer a test in school for the subject that you've taken. Again, 3 courses, there are assignments, class test, essays. Okay? And in the fourth semester, again, you will give 5 lessons, co-teaching lessons, 5 lessons in the other subject. So the first subject, maybe you have taken English, and the second subject, you have taken history. So in history, you would give 5 lessons. You have to maintain reflective journals. You have to develop learning resources. You have to organize co-curricular activities. You have to do school-based action research. 3 papers are there, or courses you call them. And you have to do the assignment, class test, and essays for each of those courses. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, I'll proceed.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Okay. Now, ma'am, what is yes, please.
But now, what if one wants to teach in junior college? What does they have to do for an internship then?
That is nothing. See, like internship, for school, they have if you are postgraduate, we give you some lessons in a junior college also. Like for our students who are MCOM and MSc and all, we send them in junior college also. Some lessons they give in junior college also, but that is not an important criteria. See, B.Ed degree, wherever exposure, wherever internship you do, that is fine, whether in junior college or this. You can get your job in a junior college. Okay?
Okay, so if I want to teach in junior college, I have to do internship in junior college only,
right?
No,
not necessary. Or is it okay? No, not necessary. But the college, like I'm telling you, on the basis of our college, we send students to junior colleges also. But it is not necessary that you have to do. Don't bother about that now. Just getting the B.Ed degree after doing your proper 4 semesters, that is essential for getting a job in a junior college. Okay? Am I clear? Fine, I'll move ahead. Let us go to the eligibility to B.Ed. And, you know, how can you be eligible? What is the criteria? I think I have already told you, you need to have minimum 50% marks in graduation. Okay? If you belong to the reserved category. Now, when I say reserved category, it is SC, ST, OBC, DT, NT, all those categories. And not the linguistic or religious minorities. For religious and linguistic minorities, you need to have 50% marks in graduation. Which graduation? If you are a BA, BCom, BSc. Okay? But if you have done BAS and BMM, BMS, BA Sociology, if you are BDS, Bachelor's in Engineering, Agriculture course, then you need to have 55% marks in graduation. Am I clear? And if you belong, if you have done your graduation from any university outside Maharashtra, okay, you need to have minimum 55% marks at graduation. How is this 50% and 55% calculated? You have to add all the six semesters. You have to add all six semesters and you have to get average. Because after the semester pattern, the universities give degree on the basis of all six semesters and not the last year marks. When you add all the marks, you have to add all six semesters. And after that, you have to see whether you have got a 15% marks or you have got 55% marks. Now, somebody may ask me, ma'am, but I have not got 50% marks if I add all those six semesters. Then do your post-graduation and try to get 50% marks in your post-graduation so that you become eligible to do the B.Ed. course. Am I clear this point? Suppose I have not got 50% marks in graduation. So what do? I don't do B.Ed. No, you can do B.Ed. Do your post-graduation, get 50% marks in your post-graduation, and then you are eligible for B.Ed. Okay, usually, normally, anybody does B.A. English Literature or B.A. History, they study six papers. But even if you have studied, you know, at your first year and second year, if you have studied three papers, those are considered. Like maybe, but in your final year of graduation, if you have done sociology or you have done philosophy, then you come under social sciences. Okay, so there are some exceptions like commerce, school science, social science, non-school science subjects. They may not have studied a school subject, but like in BCom, you don't study a school subject, but still you can get maths or you can get economics or you can get history, geography. You've done BA sociology or philosophy, but in school, for the, at the B.Ed. college, you can get English, history, geography or economics. Am I clear till you? I'll show you a chart of how this works. And of course, all have to give the CET and the ELCT exam by mistake presentation. Okay, now how are your marks calculated? Hope you all are clear. At graduation, you become eligible only if you have got 50 or 55% marks. That too, considering all six semesters. Now you have to give your CET and ELCT exam. So how are the marks calculated for preparing the merit? In CET exams, CET exam is of 100 marks and ELCT exam is of 50 marks. Suppose one person gets 60 and 30. 60 marks in CET and 30 marks in ELCT. So what is the total then?
90.
So out of 150, you have got 90. Okay, so let's say the student has done BA History or English Literature, maybe BSc candidate. Now, another student has got 50 and 38, so total is 88. Now, suppose both the students are for English Literature and a merit list is prepared. So, merit list is different for those with English Literature, those going for History, those going for Geography, those with BCom degree, those with BSc, those with BSc Mathematics, and those with, Commerce, of course, Commerce I mentioned. So separate merit lists are prepared. Now let us take this example of these two students who are BA English Literature. Who would get a preference here? Which student would get a preference?
90.
Yes. So now that student getting 90 marks has given options of all good colleges, okay? And that student has got 90. So that student will get preference over the one who's got 88. the first preference would go to one with 90% marks, the 90 score, and then the 88 one would be considered. So now tell me, what is important for you if you plan to get admission in B.Ed program in a good college? What should you do? What should you strive for?
Score good marks.
Yes? What should you strive for?
A good score.
Good score where?
In the CET.
Yes. In the CET and ELCT exam, you have to get a good score. The higher the score, like 90 plus 100, and the score cutoff is different for different subjects. So suppose you are BA English Literature and somebody is BCom. Okay? The cutoffs are different for different subjects. You can't compare yourself with one who's done BCom or one who's done BSc, who's with science or a math student. They would have a different cutoff. You are a history student, you would have a different cutoff. And you are competing, your merit list is with, it's a separate merit list for those students who have taken history or who have taken English. Remember, clear? So you have to strive. So your focus, your target should be getting maximum score in the CET exam, CET and ELCT exam, because higher your score, nobody can stop you from getting admission in a good college, aided college, good college, okay, with a good MAC grade. So this is about how marks are calculated for getting admission. Now, a quick look at this. Suppose you are Bachelor of Arts in English. Which subject will you get at the graduate in the B.Ed? In the online form, you have to enter English. You will get English subjects for teaching at B.Ed level. Okay, and you can get a job for English teacher. If you are history, history, history. Geography, geography, geography. Economics, economics, economics. But if you have done your B.A. in social sciences like psychology, political science, philosophy, then what will happen? You will enter as social sciences. So social sciences students, your merit list is different. The B.Ed program, the college can give you whatever subjects they can offer you. Whatever seats are there, they will give you those. So they can give you English, history, geography, economics. That you get after approaching the college. Also, if you have, at the last year, you have done political science. But at the first year and second year, you had taken history or you had taken English. So you can tell the college that, the B.Ed college, that I have done BA, I have studied three papers of history, one at first year and two at second year. So I've studied three papers of history. So please give me history. Okay, so you can do that. Of course, if you're Bachelor of Science, anything, biochemistry, biotechnology, physics, chemistry, biology, okay, you will get science. You have to enter science as your subject and you will get science at the B.Ed level. If you are BSc Mathematics, you will enter Mathematics, you will get Mathematics at your B.Ed. If you are Bachelor of Commerce, BCom, then you will enter Commerce, you will enter Commerce, and you will get Commerce. Now, let me make myself clear here, because many of you may be BCom and MCom students. If you get Commerce, Commerce is a subject at junior college level. There are very few colleges, just 2-3 colleges that offer commerce as a subject. Okay, so you can take commerce as a subject. But then you're eligible to teach only in junior college level. Like in our college, we don't offer commerce, but we have economics. And for Bachelor of Commerce students, we give them economics, we can give them maths, we offer them maths, we give them history, geography. So whatever they want, but we do not give them science. Because for science, you need those laboratory skills. So we don't give science. Then candidates who have done BMS, BAF, BMM, BFM, you enter under management. Okay. And again, the college would give you seat as per the availability in that college. If you have done Bachelor of Engineering or BCA or Agriculture, you come under IT Agriculture. Okay. And when you approach the college may give you suppose you are an engineering student, the college would give you mathematics. If you are a BCA or BSc IT and or an agriculture student, the college will ask you whether you want science or they give you maths. So that depends on the college. It depends on the college where you are getting admission. You have to go and talk to them. They would counsel you for this. Okay. And as I have already told you, there is a separate merit list for all this. So you come under Bachelor of Commerce, BMM, Management, separate merit list. Separate merit list for BE, BCA. Okay. Now in Maharashtra, under Mumbai University, not Maharashtra, Mumbai University, we have only one government B.Ed. college, okay, which is in opposite to Metro Cinema. And they offer their program in Marathi, okay, and they just charge tuition fees because it is a government college. Just the tuition fees, with there may or may not be facilities available, okay, because it is completely governed by the government. There are aided B.Ed. colleges, which are also coming under government. They receive aid from the government. There are 7 colleges. Like ours, one is Hansraj, there is Kapila Khandwala, St. Teresa's, St. Xavier's, Seva Sadan, Gandhi Shikshan, BTTC, Gokhale. So there are 7 colleges. These colleges will take some tuition fees plus some extra fees are considered. Unaided colleges, there are many, many. Like you go to any station, east to west, you will find one college.
I wanted to know, see, as you said that BMM students can opt for management as their subject and they can request the schools, the colleges for management as their subject. What if we want to teach in school? Is it allowed for us to teach in school or we have to just opt out for colleges, management colleges?
No. You can teach in schools. You can so get will the schools. Many nowadays, you know, with that the BAS and this degree, many 9th and 10th CBSE board schools also absorb you. They have programs such as business studies. Even IB boards and IGCSE boards have programs like business studies and all. They offer courses at the 9th, 10th level. So you can get jobs there also.
So, ma'am, we cannot go to the basic level. As I said that I had already done BMM long time ago. And after that, I had done my ECED as well. So can I go in for the other classes as well? Or I will be only allowed to go to all these schools?
So you can teach. Many of our students with BMM, BAF, they have got jobs. And they are teaching other subjects also.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Just to clarify, I wanted to know I am teaching in a school right now in the early years, that is pre-primary, since the past 9 years. So I'll have to leave my job to go through the B.Ed. course, right? It won't happen along with my job.
I think that you can approach some colleges which tell you that you need not attend and you can do that. I don't advise, but if you want, there are options available. You can check out. But if you're planning to learn something really, which is important from the NEP point of view, then of course, because our college name, you know, aided colleges, our college name only, we go with a B.Ed. degree there, they will call you for an interview. So that is the difference that is made. So you have to plan. You have to plan this beforehand, whether you can quit the job, do your B.Ed. Okay, there are 4 semesters you have to plan for, do everything. So you have to decide for yourself. You have to take your decision.
Ma'am. Okay, so after giving the entrance, where whichever college I get through, I have to speak to them, is what you are saying?
Yes. After the entrance, this is how the procedure goes.
Okay. See,
you're talking about it. This is the
procedure. Shikaya.
Okay.
Yes.
Can I have a word, please?
Yes.
Ma'am, actually right now I'm doing BA in geography. This is my final year for graduation.
Geography teachers are in demand like anything. Schools are after us. And every year, it's very difficult to get BA geography. Okay, so you would be like those hot cakes. People, schools will run after you after a BA degree. Okay? Do your BA, I would advise you.
Yeah, ma'am. So I just wanted to ask that right now with TY, can I go for CET?
But you're going to complete your TY this year and yeah. then you would do it?
Yes, no, no.
No, that you can. How like do you do
for
that?
CET, do I need my graduation marks?
Yeah, you need to. You need to have appeared for the exams, results awaited, and then you Achha. Can do your BA.
Okay, otherwise, so basically I can go for next year.
You can go year, for CET. Yeah, yes, yes.
Okay, and I've done my ECC when I was in 11. So, and I wanted to go for pre-primary or primary, not secondary section.
Don't please don't do that. With a BA geography degree, you will get jobs in secondary schools. Okay? Plan for it. Okay? Yes, can I?
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, I had a question. I have just completed my graduation in history, a BA in history, but I want to pursue my career in French since I have completed A2 in French. Do you think BA is important?
Without this BA, you can do that CIDTL course.
Okay.
But again, if you have done a BA, done a BA, you will get better job opportunities because you will have French as well as history.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
So you can teach French as well as history. So you can do BA with history, and you can teach English language. Second subject, you can take English.
Okay.
So history and English. So that would train you for teaching French also.
Oh, thank you so much.
French as a foreign language. So it's better you do BEd so you can get your salary also at par with those who have done BEd.
Yeah.
You get a good exposure about teaching a language also.
Thank you so much.
Ma'am, geography, which is second option, can I go for?
Please, let's discuss that later, okay?
Okay.
Let us come to how to get admission for the BEd course. First of all, you all have to fill up the form, and we all are waiting when the registrations would begin. The form is filled online. And remember the link, there are many links, but you have to select the right one, that is BEd, CET and ELCT link. Okay, be clear about this. Don't go for the integrated BEd MEd if you're not planning to do that, or the four-year integrated, which the link was open, now they'll close it. You have to fill up the online form, the website, I think everybody is aware. All these updates we will be putting on the WhatsApp group, www.mahacet.org. Once you apply, please maintain a folder, download the filled up form, keep it in the folder, download the receipt, because you will make payment for your admission to the government. Download the receipt, keep everything downloaded. After a few days, you will get an admit card from the website. You'll have a login. With that login, in your login, you will receive an admit card. All updates will be given on the WhatsApp group. And based on that, offline CET and ELCT exam takes place. Okay. So as soon as the government realizes that the cases are going down, they will keep the offline CET, ELCT admissions. Why is ELCT essential? If you want admission to any English medium college where the medium of instruction is English, then you have to give ELCT exam. So when you're filling up the form for BEd, please remember there is a tick mark. Do you want to give ELCT? You have to give. It has happened in the past that students who were aspiring, you know, most of you are interested in English medium colleges only. They did not select ELCT and they gave only CET. They did not get admission in English medium colleges. Okay, so you have to give your ELCT. So when you're filling up the form, please remember ELCT is compulsory if you're planning to do it from an English medium college. And nowadays you can check on the college website what is their medium of instruction. You can call up the college and find out, or you can go on their website and check. Okay, once the admission begins, the process begins, you will get the list of all colleges, which subjects they offer, which is their medium of instruction. Accordingly, because there was a query from one to candidate, he wants an admission in Hindi medium college. So you have to check out which is an Hindi medium college. Most of the colleges in Mumbai are English medium now. Okay, but there would be Hindi medium college or Marathi medium college also. So you have to give. Others who want an English medium will have to give CET, ELCT. I'm insisting our students, the participants. After you appear for the exams. One day only. You have to go one day, appear for the exams. You have to spend almost half a day goes in that exam. You get a scorecard on the website. A merit list is prepared. So you come to know where do you stand. Okay, how many people are there for English or science or maths or BCom before you? And where do you stand? So based on that. And after a few days, you will receive a message as well as your admission letter about getting admission in a college of your choice. You have to give a list of colleges. You know, preferably students give aided colleges first because they are good. In B.Ed, it is the other way around. The aided colleges are better with higher NAC grade. Of course, there are a few private colleges, one or two colleges who also have a good NAC grade that you have to see. There is a difference in fees. In aided colleges, all the teachers are highly qualified. Almost all of them are PhDs. Okay, whereas in private colleges, things may not be the same. Okay, so, but there are some private colleges which are also, they have a NAC A grade and all that. So you can check out. So before taking admission, remember any college trying to tell you, if you ask me, ma'am, is your college giving admission? I'll say, no, we don't go after students. The government will give admission. So you have to understand that any college running after you to take your admission, what is the idea behind it? Okay. Now, how to get admission? You have to appear for the CET, that is the common entrance test, and the English language content test. Based on the combined score of these two, a merit list for admission is prepared. So clear? Am I clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Can you give us the list of colleges that you mentioned earlier?
You will get the list, like how it's very, which one, aided ones. I just told you, I'll put it on the WhatsApp group. Okay.
Yes, yes.
And you will get the list, entire Mumbai University colleges, you will get on the website itself. Okay, I'll tell you about it. Okay. Now,
Good morning, ma'am. I have a doubt. Ma'am, you said about CET and ELCET, right? So both papers are going to be on one day or there are two separate exams
Same day.
No?
It's an online. See, even if you go to the exam center, it is not an offline exam. You don't have to write a manual paper. It is on the computer.
Yeah.
It is on the computer. Yeah. Yes. One by one, the questions will keep appearing. So once you complete CET and submit, ELCET exam would be. So it is okay,
immediately after that.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Ma'am. Okay.
Yes. Thank you, so ma'am. Now I'll give you details about both the exams.
Ma'am, I have a doubt.
Yes.
I'm complete my MA part 1. Now I'm studying for part 2. So now I can get admission for B.Ed?
Yes. You can get admission, but you think, do you think, ma'am, you are capable of doing two courses at a time? Because the B.Ed course is hectic. A lot of assignments, this, that. So I usually advise students, see if you can manage. At times, it has not happened, but the exam may clash. So you will give preference to your B.Ed. MA, you can always give the exams later on.
Okay, ma'am.
Because
thank
if
you.
You're doing it from IDOL, it's 4 years. Yeah.
Excuse me, ma'am. My name is Moresca Carvalho. I just wanted to know, with the given pandemic situation, even if the B.Ed course goes ahead, are we looking at an offline regular college course or we are looking at an online B.Ed course these 2 years?
Yeah, one minute. I'll just tell you about this. Maybe, you know, Maharashtra government has already come up with a circular that if you are, wherever there are less number of COVID cases or the more number of people vaccinated, gradually the courses would begin in an offline mode. So maybe by the time your admissions take place, which would go in the month of November or December, after that, we would begin in the offline mode.
Okay,
there,
ma'am. Thank
there
you.
There is a difference. Right now, we have our program going on. The students who have got admission in the month of March, first year. So we have a proper online sessions for them. Everything is done online. 11 to 5, they attend all sessions, all lectures are there. Other programs are there. Internship also, we do it online. We guide them. using a lot of tools. So our students have become so good at using all online tools, at preparing learning resources. So it was a blessing in disguise, I would say. So a college which has that quality will do it well even in the online
world. Okay.
And a college which does not offer that quality will not do it. They will not bother to do anything in the online world. Okay, that's the
difference. Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, I'll move ahead. So clear, you have to give both if you want admission in English medium college. Your combined score would be considered. Let us talk about the CET exam first. Yes.
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt. Again, as you said, like we have to do some assignment and all. So I'm also graduate person, BCom graduate in 2019. So after that, 2 years break is there. So does it make any issue for giving now?
No. It does not make any issue. There's no issue at all. Okay. Mm-hmm. That really does not matter. Even if there is a gap after completing graduation, after some years you are planning to do the BEd course, there is no issue. Only thing is, prepare well for your CET and ELCT exam. The higher the score, like for BCom students, you should get above 100 score to get admitted.
Okay. And as I'm a working person also, I'm a counselor. So, means how we can go with that, as you said, assignments?
I have already answered that question.
Okay, right. That girl asked and we can talk to the college. No issues. Yeah. But until it is online, we can go for everything. That's totally fine. Yeah.
No, don't be under that impression that until it is online, I can do counseling on one device and one device I'll attend lectures. Don't do that.
Okay, fine.
Okay, be very clear. Our mind is one. You may start on two devices, but you have only one mind. So you cannot attend on both the devices. You will neither do well there also. You will prove yourself to be not a good counselor and you will not do well in your BEd also.
BEd
also. Focus on one aspect at a time. Of course, see, even if you take admission in full-time BEd, the colleges have 6 hours of working. So after that, whatever spare time you have, you can do counseling at that time.
Okay. Like that we can go. Okay, thank you.
I'm not saying full-time jobs and all. Yes, you can work for 3 hours or something after that.
I think
I've answered people who are having a lot of questions. How will we earn? What about that? You can teach 3 hours or so. But not in a full-time job.
Okay, fine.
Because you cannot work for some 18 hours or so in a day, or let's say 13, 14 hours.
Yeah, right. And as the BA day should be the first priority.
Assignments and all also you would have.
Yeah.
So accordingly, you should have such a thing that you can manage that whenever your BA is becoming a little lot of assignments and all. So you should be able to adjust that whatever 2-3 hours counseling you are doing, and you have to manage your assignments also. You'll have to put a lot of hard work.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank Coming so to much. The CET exam, 100 questions. Okay. 100 questions, 100 marks, time 1.5 hours. 1 mark for correct answer, no negative mark. So even if you don't know, you can use elimination method, some guessing, and you can still attempt. So no negative marking. Clear with this? 1.5 hours, this exam. Only thing is you have to go to that center. So you have to go 1 hour before, 1.5 hour, then this exam, then the ELCT exam, that happens. So it takes half a day. Okay, let us see what exactly is the CET exam. Okay, there are 3 parts in the CET exam. Mental ability, questions based on mental ability, 40 questions, 40 marks. This is a set pattern. So if you want to get a good score in CET exam, you have to be ready for mental ability questions. Because 40 marks are there out of 100. Teacher aptitude, 30 questions are there, 30 marks. And general knowledge, 30 questions, 30 marks. You have to prepare for all three. Okay, I'll guide you and we will have in the next sessions that we have, we will have a separate session for mental ability. We will have a separate session for teacher aptitude. Okay. General knowledge, we will give you an idea as to what you need to read and all that. And for ELCT also, we are going to planning to have a session. Maybe next week also we may have. Next week we are planning to have a session for ELCT. Okay. Now, mental ability. How many questions for mental ability and how much percentage weightage for mental ability?
40 marks, 40%.
Yes. So 40 marks, huh? And what are the questions? They are based on series, alphabet, number series, classification, analogies, coding, decoding. Some of you must have given the national talent search exams at school level or banking exams. Okay, those kind of questions. Relationship, direction sense, blood relation, clock and calendar, and puzzle. Basically, these questions are asked to check how fast you can think, how accurately you can think, and how can you reason, how alert you are. If you practice, some of you can do wonders. So practice these questions. You can do well in these exams. Now, what are the questions? You have your paper and pen with you. Please, you can try solving this quickly. We'll quickly go through it. It's just an overview. In detail, I'll do conduct a session only for mental ability later. I'll conduct a proper 2-2.5 hour session only for mental ability. Quickly, yes, tell me. Complete the series 4, 9, 16, 25.
36.
Excellent. 36. What is the logic?
Squares of numbers.
So 4 is a square of 2, 9 is a square of 3. That is the logic. So accordingly, 6, square of 6. Complete the series. Please look out for the pattern in that series. Some pattern between numbers.
55.
What answer did you say?
54.
55.
What is the logic? 354.
It is add the number to itself and minus 2. Like double the number and minus 2.
Yes.
No, okay. Ma'am, actually, there is a difference of odd number. After 4, 9 is there. 5 will come in between both of them. After 9, in between 9 and 16, yeah, number 7 will come. In between 16 and 25, okay, 9 sir. Number will come. In between 25, after that, we have to add 11 number from 25.
Okay, fine, yeah. See, between 24 and 13, if you subtract, the difference is 11. Okay, so between 13 and 24, the difference is 11. Between 24 and 46, the difference is 22. Between 46 and 90, the difference is 44. Between 90 and 178, the difference is 88. So you are multiplying by 2 and getting that difference. So accordingly, you have to multiply 178 by... You have to multiply 178 by the earlier difference. That is, sorry, not 178, 88 multiplied by 2.
354.
I think it should be, maybe there is some error. Are you getting 354 exactly? Check out this logic.
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Excuse me. Ma'am, the correct one is you have to add.
Okay, let us discuss that later in the mental ability. I am going ahead. Okay, I can't spend a lot of time. I am not doing this question only. Is not going to come in CET exam. Uh-huh. Yeah, you're right, 354. Okay, let us move ahead. Complete this series. This is an alphabet series. The earlier was a number series. This is an alphabet series. So see what is the answer. And use a logic. There is a pattern.
Ma'am, option number B, E.
E is the answer. Okay. What logic have you applied?
Ma'am, I'm minusing my 3-3. Like, Y is on the 25th position and I minus 3. Yeah. So, I get U as 25th position.
You have to leave 3 alphabets and the 4th alphabet is the alphabet here. Okay. And fine. Next one.
B, Y. Option number B. B.
B is the answer. Okay. So one number, one alphabet from the starting and one alphabet from the end. So B second from beginning and Y second from the end. C third, X third. Like that you have to go adding and you get the logic. So see, it really requires logic and how quickly you can think. Okay. But you can do well with practice. Please mute yourself. Okay. Okay, look at this classification questions. The fifth one.
It's brass.
Aluminium.
Because it's an alloy.
Yeah,
brass is not an alloy. Brass is an alloy. Copper is an element. It's a single metal. Iron is a single metal. Aluminium is a single metal. Brass is an alloy. Combination of two metals. Look at the sixth question. So the answer is brass. Choose the...
Ma'am, textbook.
It's the sharpener. It's the sharpener. Because others are using papers. Yes. Where a sharpener is an element separate element.
The textbook is, because textbook is not a stationary item. Stationary item is pen, paper, sharpener. Textbook is something different. You can have a subject textbook. Others are just stationary items. So that is the logic. Look at this one. Analogy question. Analogies. The chef is to kitchen. Chef is the person who works. And which is the place of work? Kitchen.
Ma'am, sailor and chef.
Sailor and chef.
Sailor and chef, yeah. Next one.
Ma'am, surrender.
Be surrender. Pigeon is to peace. White flag is to surrender.
Surrender.
Coding, decoding. How you can do this, you know, all the logic, how you solve this question, we do it in the next session on mental ability. Okay. How to solve this, we will do it later. Fine.
Ma'am, I just had a question. While solving this, I realized that we need a paper and a pencil or a paper.
That is given to you. That is given to you at the center. Yes, you don't have to carry anything. You just have to carry your admit card and any ID card. Remember this, your admit card and ID card, you have to carry that as a proof. Everything, paper and a pen we have to carry. Paper is given by them, they take away the paper from you.
Ma'am, ID card as in for the...
Yeah, anything, PAN card, Aadhaar card, you have to carry for your ID proof. When you go to the center for exams. So they give you papers to solve all this.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, option number 4.
MDBFL?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, anybody else has got the logic?
Yes, MDBFL. Yes, ma'am, option 4, MDDFL. And the 10th one is...
No, sorry, that is not correct. The correct option, because T is coded as FLD. So for T, you are using F. So your letter has to begin with F, not M. Okay, you can do that, see that later. No, logic we will discuss later in mental ability. Okay. And in a certain code, farmer is coded as 562042, hot is coded as 817, hand is mother code.
I'm sorry.
It's the same option.
The correct answer is MDFL because it is gray. It is gray. My gray is not covered with the video, so I could not see it properly. The answer is MDFDFL. You are right.
Okay, ma'am. And the 10th one is, ma'am, B option.
01784. B or D option is same on 10th.
Same, ma'am. Yeah, same place. Options are given.
Good, you're very alert. I'm very happy to see you're very alert that you're noticing such errors also. Okay, look at this one, blood relation questions. Be very careful with this blood relation. How to solve this? Okay, how to draw graphics and all, graphically, you know, how you can represent, you will do in mental ability. Right now, it is just for you to see.
Sister?
I'm sister.
Okay. Sister. Next one.
I'm a sister.
Next one. Others who are not quickly getting the answers, don't worry. We will do the logic behind it, how to do it, so that you can get the correct answer. Sister. You will do in the mental ability.
Sister, ma'am.
Yeah, 11th one is sister. What about 12th one?
Sister. big is the sum of D? Okay.
The answer is D.
How B is related to C? Brother.
Cousins?
Brother.
Sir, who is senior journalist?
Uncle? Is it uncle?
The answer is actually uncle.
Yeah. Uncle.
Yeah. Look at this. This is a little tricky one, but logic, how to do it easily, we will tell you, I'll discuss later. It will take time. This question will take time, puzzle test. The logic I'll discuss in the mental ability session. I won't wait for much time. You'll take some time to do this because you really require that logic. How to do it? You require some logic. The answer is washerman and cook. Washerman and cook is the answer. Direction sense, you can draw the direction chart and do this.
I'm east.
Okay, you are right. 15th one. Please don't be under any pressure or tension. Some people are able to do it. Maybe they are used to those questions. Who are not used to? So we will teach you how to use your idea, logic to solve this kind of questions. You can do it. Practice, you can do it better. Please mute yourself. There is Pythagoras theorem involved in the system. The Pythagorean triplet, 7th standard, 15 question. Taj Kumari, please mute yourself.
Ma'am, 10.
Yeah, right.
10.
What about this? The entire idea, how do you solve? We will do it later. Because now my purpose is the BEd admission process. This is just an overview of that.
First one is 24.
No, it is 22. Logic, I'll let you know later in the mental ability session. 22. Answer is 22. Because in 12 hours, it is only 11 times that the two hands coincide. It is not 12 times. Only 11 times they coincide. So in a day of 24 hours, 11 into 2, 22 times. 17th, you see the logic, how many times they coincide? It is 11 times they coincide. The next one.
Tuesday, B.
Yes, you are right. Okay, so that was about mental ability. 40 questions, 40 marks, and those kind of questions you can expect. Next is teacher aptitude. Now, this teacher aptitude test. Any idea what do you mean by aptitude? Where does this word aptitude come from? One apt for. Are you apt? Are you fit to become a teacher? So if you have the teacher aptitude, anything related to how education is taking place during the pandemic period, the National Education Policy, Right to Education Act, you will read up about it. And the questions, okay, on leadership qualities, awareness about changes in education and society, communication, professional commitment. Related to this, there are questions on teacher aptitude. Let us see what kind of questions are there. Don't think it's very easy to apply logic.
Ma'am, tell a story.
Yes, very good.
B, tell a story.
Yeah. Second one.
I'm option B.
Yes. Message, yes. Question answer is send a message that you would come after the class because that is your professional commitment with the students. Okay. Teacher aptitude. Next question. So giving feedback to students about their performance. On what basis would you give their feedback? Them feedback.
Facts.
Whatever is the marks, where they are good at, what do you see in the class? So based on facts, you will give them feedback. Who's the father of educational psychology?
A. John Dewey.
It is Edward Thorndike.
Okay.
In modern, they say, but it's Edward Thorndike. What is the purpose of continuous comprehensive evaluation? You must be aware, since 2010, this continuous comprehensive evaluation has come, based on which
we have progress of students.
Yes. It ensures progress of students.
B.
Okay, which method of teaching would you prefer to teach some content?
Activity-based method. Activity-based method, ma'am.
Not necessary. Every time you will use activity-based method.
Depend upon the content.
Depends on the content that we taught.
Depend upon the
content. So those are teacher aptitude for 30 marks, 30 questions. And last is general knowledge, 30 questions, 30 marks. So all general knowledge. I usually advise students that, the participants, candidates for B.Ed. Admission, please read up CBSC board books which are available on the internet, standards 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. Your UN, your Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, how do elections take place, your state assembly, a lot of ideas about the democratic process, everything is there. And of course, I would advise to read up your school level textbooks, CBSE board books, science and technology, history, geography, civics, and a little about current events. Okay, the little about current events. Maybe now you can have questions on coronavirus, the COVID-19 pandemic, okay, which vaccines are there. You may expect questions of that kind also. And in teacher aptitude, you can expect questions on national education policy. So I will prepare a small brief summary and all of national education policy and put up on your WhatsApp group whenever I get time. Civics, okay? All the basic ideas. You should know about different countries, their capitals. You should know about the history of India, the freedom struggle, who were the people involved, Indian National Congress. All these ideas you should know. Was the first president, first prime minister, okay, on which dates did we get India become republic, which day we got independence, okay? So general knowledge questions could be something like this. Viceroy of India, when India got independence, who was it?
Lord Ivan.
Mountbatten. Lord Mountbatten. First lady president of Indian National Congress?
Sarojini Naidu.
Annie Besant.
Vijay Lakshmi Pandit.
No, it is Annie Besant.
Okay.
She was the first. Which is the longest river in the world?
Nile.
Yeah, and what if we ask India? You should know that. Okay. The person appointing, see, all this is covered in the civics part in CBSE board books. Person appointing Chief Justice of India. Who appoints?
President.
Which of the following countries, your UN, bodies of UN, Security Council, General Assembly, who has veto power, who is there in Security Council? So which country does not have a veto power in Security Council? Maybe the G7 summit, the G7, the BRICS. So this idea, what is it? You should know who are the members.
Canada,
yeah. Okay, so all these are the correct answers. ELCT. So that was with respect to CET exams. Okay. So you're clear about what kind of questions are asked for the CET exams. You can start preparing. And every week, we are planning to have one session on mental ability, on teacher aptitude. So we will guide you accordingly. Of course, my videos are available on the YouTube. You can check out that also. But if you want in a face-to-face mode, you can attend this. MCQs, B.Ed. ELCT exam pattern. MCQ based. Don't think that my English is good. I speak good English, so I will do well in ELCT. It does not happen that way. You need to have basic knowledge of English grammar, your comprehension ability should be good. So you have to practice all this. So even if you take comprehension, you know, any CBSE board workbook or CBSE board textbooks, English textbooks, you'll find such passages there and you can practice those. MCQs, it is MCQ based, total questions 50, total marks 50. So for one mark for every correct answer, no negative marking. Exam time 1 hour after CET exam, for 1 hour you give ELCT exam. The full form is English language content test. Okay. Now, what is the portion, the syllabus? There are 20 marks. Out of 50 marks, 20 marks is for reading comprehension. We will see what exactly does it mean. Vocabulary focus, meaning of words and all that, 5 marks for that. Grammar focus, so your grammar related questions, 8 marks. Sentence formation related questions, 7 marks. Some phonetics, very little, only 3 marks for phonetics. Verbal idioms and proverbs, 5 marks. And figures of speech, 2 marks. So if you prepare, you can do very well in this exam. We have had students who have got 47 and 46, 47 also in English ELCT exams. Okay. Now, let us see that reading comprehension is of 20 marks. So for 20 marks, there are 4 comprehensions, 5 marks. The first one is picture comprehension. Look at this picture. Very easy. Just you have to look at the picture very critically. Okay. Of course, the picture is always there in front of you. So you can look at the picture and answer the question. Okay, what is the mother doing? What is the mother doing?
Knitting.
Weaving. Knitting.
Sleeping. Knitting. There is no weaving here. Okay, what is the father reading?
Newspaper.
Excellent. How many children are present?
Two.
Okay, then the next is 20 marks, 5 marks for picture comprehension. The next 5 marks are for poem comprehension. Read the poem carefully.
Option B.
Wait. Let the other people read the poem.
It's option B, vehicles and
people. I said wait for a minute. Okay. You are in such a hurry. What is the meaning of traffic and feet?
Vehicles and people.
Very good. What does the poet wish for? Check here. Meadows and lands. Where is it? Meadows and lands?
Forest.
Excellent. Forest. Where does the poet feel there is a lot of space?
Sky.
Okay. Similarly, there would be a passage. Like how at 8th, 9th standard, we used to have a comprehension passage. So you'll have a passage and a questions based on this. The same, we will do it in our English language content test. Orientation, which we would have on next Friday. Next Friday, we are keeping ELCT session also. So we train you for this in depth. Okay. So what have I covered up till now? Yeah. There is a picture comprehension, poem comprehension, passage comprehension, and a dialogue comprehension. All that we will see in the, there's a dialogue between two people and you have to comprehend the dialogue. So 5 marks for comprehension. Don't you think it's very easy to get these marks if you practice and try and you are alert? You can get good marks in this comprehension itself. Okay, coming to grammar focus. Add question tag. Please refresh your grammar part.
Isn't she?
Kevin will come home today.
Won't he?
There's a logic how you convert that. I am clever, am I not?
Aren't I?
Okay. Then change interrogative sentence to assertive sentence. No, it's the other way around. Sorry, change assertive sentence to interrogative sentence. Sorry for that. It was a great sight.
Was it a great sight?
You're not asking a question. Was it a great sight? You say, what a great sight.
How great the sight is.
So,
what a great sight.
No one can tolerate this.
Can anyone tolerate this?
Can anyone tolerate this?
vocabulary focus. Okay. What is the meaning of the word augment? The
meaning of word.
Increase.
Increase. Remember, these questions are nowadays.
Increase.
Yeah. Yeah. I've taken actually some of these questions are actually from the exam.
What is the meaning of the word?
Fetch.
Get.
Bucket.
I'm get.
Fetch is not get. Bucket. Get. Fetch is get. What is the meaning of the word command?
Order.
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 What is the antonym? You have antonym and synonyms, homonyms. Yes, yes. You should know all the things. What is the antonym of the word theoretical? The opposite of theoretical is practical.
Theoretical.
What is the synonym of the word evaluate? Similar.
Assess.
Assess. What is the homonym? Homonym are same sounding words. I'm sorry. Yeah, they are the same sounding words, but the meaning is different. Okay,
can of Pepsi.
Idioms and phrases. He burned the candle at both ends for his final exam.
Exhausted himself.
Exhausted himself.
The meeting was put off.
Postponed.
Figures of speech, the basic figures of speech, not the higher ones.
My love.
Alliteration.
My love is like red rose. Red.
Repetition.
Yeah,
Simile also.
No, sorry, it's a repetition. No, it's a repetition.
Climax.
Climax. Swam is a farmer's best friend.
Personification.
It is a metaphor. Okay.
It's a metaphor.
Metaphor. We are comparing.
Comparing.
Okay. We will see that, you know, we will see in the English language, we have other people, other teachers who will help you with the ELCT. Okay. Determine the correct order. I'm just giving this idea. Just questions. Correct
Four.
Order.
B1.
I'm option
one,
B.
Option B.
Option B.
Option
B.
4132. He had fever. He consulted the doctor. The doctor gave him medicines. He felt better.
Yeah.
So mostly, yeah. I have completed whatever part I was supposed to do in this B.Ed. admission process. This is my number. Please request you don't call me up because I'm very busy with my admission, with my college work. Please send a WhatsApp whenever I get time. You know, I answer. And don't expect that you put up a message immediately, you will get an answer. I will see your messages, okay? And there are others also who keep helping, those who are with me. There are some candidates who were there last year also and they want admission again for this year. So they will. There are people who will be helping you out, okay?
Ma'am?
Now, any question answers that you have, you can put ma'am? In the chat. I'll keep my chat open. And of course, you can ask also.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Like there are many teachers who teach like science and English in school, right? So when you told us to put like for bachelors of science, we have to put science as a subject. So in school, will I get to teach English too?
Usually we give science and maths to students. It's a odd combination. Science and literature. Have you studied literature to teach English?
Yeah,
don't, you know, you, just because you feel that I can teach English doesn't mean, have you studied English literature to teach in a school? Think about the school students also. Let an English literature person teach English. Okay, or maybe at the graduation level, you've done history, but you can teach English at the lower level. Second subject you can take. But with science, we give maths.
Excuse
a good
me,
combination
ma'am.
While getting jobs also.
Ma'am Moreska here, I just wanted to ask you, I have done my BA in sociology and I was under the impression that the last year, the TY marks are what is required minimum of 50% is of the TY. But in your course of your explanation, you mentioned six terms and the total of which. So what I want to ask you is,
It's the average percentage.
But do I have to do that calculation and see whether I qualify for the application form or does
the college check it? Which university?
Mumbai University.
It is even for the 3 years that earlier semester annual pattern, for that also you need to take average. You need to check.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Anything else?
Ma'am, I would want to ask one question. They say that the Mumbai University, the university are better to opt for when it comes to B.Ed. courses. So is it something like that the B.Ed., the university, like Mumbai University, will have a more weightage than the other institutes that are offering B.Ed. courses?
Like what?
For the course, like the Mumbai exam. University. Like so if I have done my B.Ed. Mumbai. From, yes. So, like Mumbai University itself has a course, or we have to get into these colleges which is offered by Mumbai University?
Through the CET examination, all the colleges are offered to you. So, you want Mumbai University, get Mumbai University colleges. There are many colleges under Mumbai University.
Okay. And ma'am, one more thing I wanted to ask, that now the CET course will, the CET exams will be held and the B.Ed. Admissions will be happening later on.
Yeah, it will take a little time. It will take some time.
Okay.
Because
okay.
Just now I told you in the month of March, we completed our admission. Usually that admission was supposed to be done in the month of November. October, we were supposed to complete, and November, the college was supposed to start. So we started college in the month of March. Okay, almost month of March, we started college. So now the first year are still there in the second semester. So let them at least complete. They would complete by September, October. So your admissions would begin by that time.
Okay, thank you so much.
Ma'am, just a query. For home science graduates, is there a separate merit list, ma'am?
Home science is under non-school subjects. But then you can take science and all. We have had students who have taken science for home science. Okay, because you have studied home science, science at home science, no? You can get.
Yes. Okay, ma'am.
Some subjects of home science. You can get science.
Ma'am, I want to ask you that is there any particular book in under which all these subjects come, like mental ability, general knowledge?
There are many books like Upkar, Arihant is there, Upkar. See that the book is specially meant for B.Ed. CET. Okay? And there are answers given at the end. You can check out. There are, if you put on the Google, there are people who will tell me.
Okay. And ma'am, should we have to take particular classes for that? Like we have to take admission in particular institute for practicing mental ability or
No, please don't like do that. There is no need. We will be conducting sessions. I told you we are conducting sessions free of charge for you. Okay. So why do you want to go to any private coachings, pay money there? We are there. We will guide you completely. We will tell you what you need to study, how you need to study. Study, put your own efforts. Nobody is going to give you ready-made solutions. You have to put in your own efforts. And then if you put
great,
in efforts, you are preparing for your
providing.
Yeah. I'll be thank answering you, the questions thank in the chat in some time. Okay. Any more questions?
Okay. Yes, hello, ma'am.
If you have put a question in the chat, don't ask. Okay.
Yes. Ma'am, with respect to the combination of, like, I've done my bachelor's in English literature. So, by the explanation, I get a choice of English. Yeah. So, am I just restricted to that subject in school level? Or
so
can
you
I
can take English, history, and geography also?
Yes. Okay.
Second, okay, there are two methods. In B.Ed., yes, we offer two methods. Like first main is English, and second also you can take history or geography. Okay? Okay. So you are eligible to teach two subjects. Even for job, you know, when you get job opportunities, you can tell them that I know English also, I can teach history also. And that is what is seen from my qualifications. And you can teach.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, I have completed my graduation in English literature and I've done C1 level in French and I wish to become a French teacher at secondary school. So which subject should I choose in my B.Ed. along with English?
Nobody is going to give you French in B.Ed. None of the colleges have.
Okay.
But what you can do is you can take English. You have done B.A. in which subject?
English literature and education.
So why don't you take, you'll get B.A. English literature. Or at least get B.A. English literature and second subject you can take history. So in a way you are trained for a language, you can take up French also.
Okay.
When you join school.
Ma'am, I am a GOM student and I want to teach in junior college, but my preference is maths. So which other subject I can choose?
You can get economics also. If you're planning to go for junior college, you can go for economics or commerce.
So only those two are the subjects which I can choose.
Yeah, so what else can you teach? You want to teach all the subjects or what? No.
For junior college, yeah. If I am a BCom student, which are the subjects
you
that
can
I can...
Accountancy. See, at B.Ed, we can give you history, geography. But then at the junior college, you can teach accountancy or commerce or in that whatever is there.
Okay.
Hi, ma'am. Hello.
Yes.
This is Rakesh over here. I would like to, I've completed my bachelor's from biotechnology and my master's from environment science.
1 minute, from where? Bachelor's from?
Biotechnology.
Okay, no issues.
And master's from environment science, yeah. So, can I teach maths and science?
You'll get science first because your main subject is science. So, science and maths as your combination.
Okay.
For BSc students, we give science and maths as a combination. But if you've
and
done
BSc college?
Mathematics... junior college, you can teach your environmental science, whatever is your subject the college gives you.
Okay.
Okay.
So but science and maths option.
Yeah, science and maths you will do, but at the college will give you subject.
Okay. It depends on college. Fine. Thank you.
Yes. Any more questions or should I take the questions from the chat?
Ma'am, one last question. What is the cutoff of your college?
For different subjects, it is different. If you are BCom, you should get almost above 90. English literature, it can go to 70. Gradually, it goes to 70, but initially starts with higher score. Second round, third round, it keeps coming down.
And ma'am, your college is Gujarati minority quota, right?
Yeah, it is Gujarati.
Is there a difference?
Yeah, I'll just tell you about this.
Yes,
our
ma'am.
Our college is a Gujarati linguistic minority college. That means we have 50 seats.
Okay,
out of the 50 seats, 25 seats are reserved for the Gujarati community because the college is started by Gujarat. The management is for the welfare of minority, Gujarati minority. So if your mother tongue means your language, mother tongue is Gujarati. They're not saying Gujarati community. Your mother tongue is Gujarati. You can apply in the Gujarati quota of our college. But remember, or you can apply for Christian quota, or the Muslim quota, or the Sikh quota, okay? So, you can apply for that quota, but please be careful when you're filling up the form. When you're filling up the form, there is a question asked, do you belong to any religious or linguistic quota? You have to click there. So, please, when you're filling up the form, first thing is check the B.Ed, CET, LCT link, and then when you're filling up the form, check for two things. One is the ELCT exams. You have to click. If you don't click, you'll create problems. Sure. And second is, if you belong to religious or linguistic minority, click on that, the correct one. And of course, if you belong to the reserved category, click on that also. But for that, you need to have proper certificates. I showed you the brochure last year.
If you belong to Gujarati linguistic, is there any specific document we have to upload?
There's nothing as such. You just need your performa. I'll show you all that. Okay, I have the last year's information brochure. I'll show you that.
Ma'am, one more question, ma'am. This is with regards to admission process. It might be a basic question, but I would like to know that once our CET marks are out and we have shortlisted few colleges in, I would like to do my B.Ed. So we have to personally go to the college or how is it? How is once the CET
results? Once your results are out, scores are declared, maybe after 8-10 days, you have to fill up the optional form. Okay. Once you filled up the CET application form, then the second time after your results are out, you have to fill up the optional form. In the optional form, again, if your results are out, you can fill up data and you have to give a list of colleges as per your preference. So they give you a college depending on your CET score, ECET, LCET score as per your choice. You have to select your college.
So the optional form will be available online?
Online. Okay. We will give you all updates. It is on the website itself. That is the procedure how it goes. So we will give you all the updates. As soon as the optional form is open, we will give you updates.
And in the optional forms, each college give their cutoff also. So we have to check with the CET score and then accordingly apply?
Don't do all that. Just apply. Check out which is a good college and apply. You can change the options in the second round and the third round also. They give you that choice.
Okay, is there are three rounds. Okay.
Three rounds, four rounds. Last round is the spot admission round, where okay. there are seats vacant in any colleges. You go and approach those colleges directly.
Hello, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Ma'am, I wanted to ask that...
I cannot hear you. You're very slow. Soft.
Hello, ma'am.
Huh?
I actually wanted to ask that how did she ask for that admission process only similarly? So how do we have to apply for like Gujarati quota? Like how?
I just told you when you're filling the form, be very careful. There is this, do you belong to religious or linguistic minority? Be very careful when you're filling the form. Do not fill up in a hurry.
Okay.
Check everything properly. It is asked there. So that time only you have to fill. If you don't fill, then you don't get an opportunity.
Okay. Thank you.
I am answering the questions from the chat and then I'll show you the information.
Hello, ma'am.
Huh?
I have done my graduation in sociology. So what subjects I get?
You can get history, whatever the college gives you, history, English, geography.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, I'll just take the questions from the link. Ma'am, will it be right for an aspirant who wants to teach in pre-primary or first year? In international school? Yeah, you can do your B.Ed, state board school. You can do B.Ed even if you want to teach first, second, third, fourth. Okay, so a commerce graduate won't be able to choose maths as their subject. Radhika, you can select maths as your subject. But initially, you have to write commerce. And then when you go approach the college, you have to tell the college, I want maths. They'll give you, depending on this availability of seats. Then Vidhi says, can you please share the PPT? My YouTube link, the recording is available on the link, on our college link. The earlier, last year, whatever sessions I conducted, it is available. Plus, whatever I'm conducting today would be available in a few days' time on the link. I'll send you the link. Is that fine? I won't share the PPT because I don't want anybody to misuse the PPT, okay? But the entire session is there on your YouTube. Ma'am, by what name we can check your videos? There are already videos are there. Plus, we are uploading the new this today's video also. Achha, last year's papers of CET exams. The last year papers as such are not available, but we will still check. The papers, remember this exam is online. And they don't allow anyone to, they don't leak their papers. They don't allow the questions to be out in any manner. Okay, but whatever books you are solving or this, you will get an idea. And whatever questions we would be discussing, they have come in the CET exams. I'm a graduate in sociology and education. So ma'am, is there any issue? No issues. Does your college provide B.Ed for science? Yes, we provide B.Ed for science, maths, English, history, geography, economics. What are the timings of our college? Each college has different timings. Our college timings are from 11 to 5. Usually any college works for 6 hours. When you have internship, you go to schools. But maybe going to schools right now is not done. But yes, we do it online. Tentative dates of CET exams. Hopefully the exam process, form filling process would begin in the month of August. The date may be end of August or September. So you have good 2 months time to prepare. So prepare. Okay. There are questions. Can we do MCOM and B.Ed at the same time? I think I've answered this question. You can. If the, you go to university, check. Okay. But let me tell you, MCOM and B.Ed, you're neither paying attention to your B.Ed, you're neither paying attention to your MCOM. And you have to prepare for your MCOM, your exams. At the same time, your B.Ed would be there. So see how you can manage. Okay. We don't have any issues. You want, you take admission, but it becomes very, very hectic. And then there are chances you will not get good marks in your MCOM. Shouldn't happen that way. Okay. Can we do MA and B.Ed? I think we have, I've told you. Check with the university whether your course is allowed. A particular year they did not allow. Then they allowed. All that has happened. So for us, there is no issue. If you want, you do. But let me tell you, it becomes very hectic. In a way, you cannot do this properly, you cannot do that properly. So why don't finish your B.Ed. and complete your M.A.? Or even if you take admission, give your exams later or something like that. Ma'am, I'm a graduate in education and English literature, and also I've done history in my F.Y. Will I get to teach? Yes, you will get history, English, whatever you want. Watch your videos. If you want to watch the last year's videos, you can go to Hansraj Jivandas College of Education link and type my name, Vaishali Sawant, on the orientation to B.Ed. course. Those last year videos are available. Today's video, we will send you the link. I have graduated in education and psychology and also history. Will I get to teach? See, that is the school's decision, what they want to. They feel you are good at it, they will teach, allow you. Ma'am, what is the fees for B.Ed. aided colleges? Students, the B.Ed. college fees goes to around 40,000, around 38 to 40,000 per year. All the entire thing, whatever other things, stationery and all that is provided to you, you can check that. The fees is given on the information brochure also. Okay, but in private colleges, the fees is very high. Ma'am, I have completed graduation with history and literature and history from IDOL. Do we have to add up all the 3 years score? Yes. You have to add up all the 3 years scores and get the average for that 50%. For BSc Maths, what is the cutoff? It will go to 80 or something, BSc Mathematics. Ma'am, I have applied psychology, also done my with subjects will I get. You can get English history or something of that sort. Ma'am, do I need any document for my B.Ed. CET, Virali Shah? I'll tell you about the performa. Oh, just give me some time. Ma'am, what is the payroll for teachers different in government and private schools? Let me tell you, students, there are hardly any jobs in government schools. There are no appointments. Maybe once in a while, there may be a job in government school, but they keep you as section sevak for initial 3 years. After that, they give you full package. So that full package would go to around 40,000-45,000. Okay, right now, before the lockdown, our teachers were getting, if they were PG, they were getting something like 50,000 for 11th and 12th standard. Some of them have got, with a graduation degree, have got something like 40 and all those. But it depends. Now with the online mode, teachers are teaching in the online mode right now. So people who are getting jobs may get 7,000 to 8,000 less. But once it changes to online mode, again, you would get your pay package. Ma'am, I have done my graduation. What is DAVB with any extra document? What is my done my graduation, Bhavna Joshi, with DAVB?
Yeah, ma'am, this is DAVB University. This is MP, Madhya Pradesh University. Okay. DAVB.
Okay. I'll talk about it. You will come under, you have done it from DAVB. No, you will come under other than home university quota. There is a 2% quota for other than home university, but in the SWOT admission round, the number goes up. So
is that difficult to get the admission? Is that difficult?
Not really. If you have a good score, so try to get very high score in CET, ALCT. And Bhavna Joshi, are you a Gujarati? No,
ma'am. I'm Marwadi actually.
So you come under the normal quota because you will not be eligible for the Gujarati quota. If you have done your graduation from any university outside Maharashtra, then you are not eligible for the quota. Then you are not eligible for...
So do we need any document like from the DAVB domain certificate, something
like
that?
No, that migration and eligibility will happen later. Once you get admission, the college will tell you. When will the registration...
In the CET form, while we are filling the CET form, do we have to attach the document or normal degree only?
Normal degree, but you will go under OHU, other than home university quota.
Other than
quota
home.
Is different. You are not home university student, so you'll go in.
So
other
I can
than home.
I can continue with the Maharashtra University as well. There's any problem?
No issues. Ma'am, when the merit list are out, do we have to secure a seat?
Thank you, ma'am.
Even I want to wait. You can wait whatever you want. That we will discuss later. So if you get admission, you take admission. If you're very sure you don't want to take admission, don't take admission and wait for the second round. What is the YouTube channel name? It's Hansraj Jivandas College of Education. You can go to college and click on B.Ed. orientation. You will get it. I don't recommend doing post-graduation and B.Ed. together. I don't recommend. I would tell you not to do it. Because in some, if you're planning to go abroad, they don't recognize the dual degree. Okay, I recommend not to do it. Do it gradually to have an entire lifetime. So do your B.Ed properly, do your MA after that or M.Com after that. I don't recommend anything. I have seen students not doing very well when they try to do both.
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes.
Ma'am, I've done my B.A. in economics, even done MA in economics, and I am currently doing CIDTL course also. And I've done my PGCI course. So do you think, should I continue with B.Ed as I'm...
See, ultimately, there are schools which in India prefer B.Ed. So if you can do it, well and good. Otherwise, join. This is some information given to me by my own students who are working in schools. They say that the pay package differs if you do not have a B.Ed degree.
And ma'am, if we are working, and can we do simultaneously while
working? Can you check out? I think I've already told you that B.Ed is a full-time. Now, after that, you want to do some, what the word used is, you want to do some jugaad, you check out. I don't recommend such jugaad.
Okay, thank you.
I have done MSc in botany, so my first subject would be science, but for second subject, you will take maths. How can you go for history? You are a MSc botany, and suddenly you want to take history. You want to take, what about the school students? Let some BA history person teach history to them. I'm already completed. Will there be any problem? See, Kushi Joshi, if you have done first year of graduation, you can take admission. But if you possible, don't give exam in the same year. You can give exam later, because in IDOL, you can give your exams in 4 years' time. So you can do, see what is possible. That's your decision.
Will there be any clashes in the dates, like a B.Ed ka exam will also be in June?
Ho sakta hai. See, I'm not saying ki nahi hota hai. Nahi hota, but ho sakta hai. Once in a while, it can happen. And if that happens, you don't give the MA exam. Clear your B.Ed first, and then next year you give your MA or M.Com exam. Achha, somebody is 12th standard pass. Yeah, after 12th standard pass, you can do B.A. B.Ed. Yes, you can, but not this year. This year, there is no B.Ed, B.Ed in Mumbai University. It would start in some colleges next year, not now.
Ma'am,
for a particular, if I don't take admission, no. If you don't take admission in the college allotted to you, usually it is recommended ki take admission. You will get your refund and you can take admission in the second round. They still give you a choice. So that we will discuss when the time comes, okay? Because we have to see that there is a float and freeze option. So we will see that, okay? I have done graduation in BAS. I've been done 3 years assistant in high school. No, see, primary grade for B.Ed, if you're planning, you know, you want to teach in primary grade in B.Ed, we don't go till primary grade. Of course, we go till 5th standard, 6th standard, we allow. But we don't go to 1st and 2nd standard in B.Ed. So we ask you to teach at the 5th, from 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th till junior college. What is the role of second subject that we take? Is this subject, can we teach in school in option to the main subject? Yes. So when you go to any, for any job interview, you can tell that I have done B.Ed in this English and history. So if they have a vacancy for history, they'll consider you. That is the idea. And there is no vacancy for English. You have choice now. Can you please the list of good B.Ed colleges? Okay, I'll send you the aided colleges list. I'll give you in some time. I'm Gujarati. So do we have Gujarati quota? What documents? Yeah. If you are Gujarati from Mumbai, you're born in Mumbai, in Maharashtra, you're born in Maharashtra, then you can apply for Gujarati quota. I'll tell you what document is required. Ma'am, when the merit lists are out, do we have to secure, even if I want to wait for the second round? I think we will discuss this when the admissions are begin, because we all are on the WhatsApp group. How do we approach the colleges for internship? You don't approach the colleges for internship. We give you the colleges and schools for internship. You don't approach anything. Second preference with government, which other subject with geography? Geography, you can take English history also. Sorry, not history. With geography, you can take English, economics, maths in our college. The colleges will give you. Okay. I want to share something with you. This is the last year's information brochure. So once the admission begins, you will get an information brochure like this. This is last year's. Huh? You can see the index. to show you this and then stop. Okay, look at this. There were some questions about domicile certificate. So look at this. If you are born in Maharashtra, you will have a birth certificate saying that you are born in Maharashtra. Okay. Then you need not submit a domicile certificate. And you come under category A, type A, if you are born in Maharashtra. Okay. But if you have a birth certificate from Maharashtra, you need not bother about domicile certificate. But if you come under minority quota, okay, if you come under minority quota, you have to tell you. If you come under minority quota, okay, you're getting admission under minority quota, you need a domicile certificate, even if you are born in Maharashtra. Okay, so you come under candidate type A, but you need to have a birth certificate stating born in Maharashtra. You do not need a domicile certificate. Any of you who do not have a birth certificate of Maharashtra, then what to do? Can I come under type A? You can. For that, you have to prepare a domicile certificate stating that you have been staying here for last more than 10 years. Okay, if you're not born in Maharashtra, if you do not have a birth certificate stating Maharashtra, then you will need a domicile certificate. Okay. Okay. So if you are not born, type B, candidate does not satisfy the upper this, then if your father or mother is domiciled in the state of Maharashtra and possess a domicile certificate, okay, that would be. But if your parents, you're not born in Maharashtra, but your parents, your father or your mother is employed with the Maharashtra government, okay, then you will come under category C. You have to get a letter about your parents working with the government undertaking. Okay, so accordingly, you come under different categories. Can you see this? I've highlighted all the minority candidates. The minority candidature, this candidate will have to submit domicile certificate of the state of Maharashtra. And if you have done your graduation, you're Gujarati or you're Catholic, and you've done your graduation from other universities, from other states, then you do not come under that minority. Remember that, okay?
Hello, ma'am.
If you belong to the reserved category, okay, then you have to submit your caste certificate and you have to submit your caste validity certificate or non-creamy layer certificate. So if you're applying under quota, reserved category quota, please get your caste validity or the non-creamy layer certificate. Apply for it. Okay, at the time of form filling, you can upload the receipt that you have applied for it. And when the certificate comes, you can submit the certificate. So if you're applying under reserved category, you need two documents. Okay. A few things I want to share. Yeah. If you come under the economically weaker section, you need to have proper documents. Okay. You will not get preference in admission, but the government will, there are some provisions. So see, everything is mentioned here. 50% marks for which subjects and 55% marks for which subject. And if you are from other university, you need 55% marks. This is a big document that you have to read up. What document, actually, this is for NRI candidates. Okay, some of you were asking me questions about the what documents you require. if you belong to normal, you know, all candidates, all of you have to submit your, see, this is it, your FYSYTY degree marks memo. Okay, so this is needed. Degree marks to marks, convocation certificate is optional. You need not submit convocation certificate, but you need your FYSYTY mark sheets. Post graduation, if you have done, you have to submit your post graduation marks. You need to keep your CET scorecard. You need to have your admit card or your hall ticket. You need to have your CET application form. Everything you have to download and keep. You need to have your, either your birth certificate or domicile certificate mentioning your place of birth. If it is Maharashtra, you do not need a domicile certificate. But if it is not Maharashtra, then you will need a domicile certificate. See here, can you see this? Maharashtra type A candidate, you need a domicile certificate or birth certificate or school living certificate mentioning your place of birth, where you know, which was the place of birth. And as you can see, the caste and all, everything is there. Even for defense category, there are some seats. Once this document is out, please try reading it. Can you see all the students trying to apply under the Catholic or the Gujarati or the Muslim minority? Can you see here? It says that you have to give a declaration in Performa O. I would advise, please give this Performa O only. Avoid giving school living certificate. Try to give the Performa O only and domicile certificate essential. It's written here. Am I clear? All those who are coming under minority quota, you will need your Performa O and a domicile certificate. Now, where is Performa O? It's here only at the end. Can you see this Performa O? This is the declaration. So what you have to do, you just have to put your name, resident. You have to mention which minority do you belong to and put the date and sign. That's it. This is your Performa O. You don't need any other document. Of course, you need the domicile certificate. So if you are planning to apply under minority quota, which would be giving you an advantage, please apply for your domicile certificate. Okay. And if the admission begins by then, please upload at least the receipt of that domicile certificate. Yes, candidates. Okay. Am I clear? This is Performa O. It's available. It would be available on the website. Okay. You just have to take a printout of this form, fill it and put it as Performa O. And your domicile is there. Okay. What was asking me a question?
Ma'am, can you share
ma'am, the Performa O certificate we have to give?
I will give you the link, but this is last year's document, okay? They will make changes in this document.
Okay, so while taking the admission, we just need to give this certificate to the respective college, right? That has nothing to do
with the one minute. When you're filling the optional form, after your results are out, you have to fill up the optional form. When you're filling up the option form, you have to upload all these documents. You have to scan these documents and upload. You have to keep all your documents ready. Okay?
Okay.
And upload it on the website. Okay. We will give you instructions about that. So keep all your documents ready, especially the domicile certificate, your caste certificate, and as I have told you, where what you require a domicile certificate. Please keep all that ready.
Ma'am,
where can we find this document right now for current year?
No, it is not there. No, that would take time. Once the admission is out, the admission process begins. That time they give this document and they make changes. So I don't want to give it to you. So I refer to this document. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. You can share so that we can get the list.
Okay. I'll put it up. But remember, this document is for last year. Okay. I'll put it on the group. Yeah.
And ma'am, also, I wanted to ask that.
Yeah, can I do MA in Hindi or BA? Yes, you can do MA in Hindi if you want to teach Hindi. And you can teach in schools Hindi. But many colleges do not give BA Hindi. Some colleges offer BA in Hindi. So check out that. Anything else?
Ma'am, just to confirm, linguistic minority, we have to get a domicile and performa, right?
Yes.
And
I'm for your domicile right now. Even if by the time you have to upload documents, you have a receipt of the domicile, upload the receipt. And when you actually get admission, try to get that domicile. Nowadays, you get domicile in 15 days' time. There is a website called as aplesarkare.com. So there are, you know, we will put up on the group all that. So you apply on the...
I have one doubt. The domicile we need is a state of Maharashtra. And the linguistic is Gujarati. So is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, just 1 minute to add to this, what she said, you also had mentioned about caste certificate. So what is caste
certificate? I would like to mention about the caste certificate. Caste certificate, if you belong to reserved category, the SCST quota, okay? Then you need caste certificate. Okay. Not for other
minority. Quota. Not for minority.
Not for minority. You don't need a caste certificate. You need only your performa O and domicile. Those who are applying under caste, please remember the caste certificate should be from the government of Maharashtra, not from any other government or not from any other state government. Okay, that is given in the brochure. You cannot be reserved category from declared by any other state. You have to be declared by the state of Maharashtra only. Then only you are eligible for reserved category admission, whatever. Privileges or facilities are there. Okay.
And for the Gujarati minority certificate, I have got it from my current
wherever you get it from, please unmute yourself. What is the harm in preparing this performa O and uploading it? That is the best, safest thing. Because you get it from your community, and if that is not properly written or something, you will have issues. So instead of that, why bother about it? Just fill up the performa O and upload it. That's what is it.
Then I don't need any community certificate at Gujarati.
So,
okay.
I would advise you to go for performa O rather than any community certificate.
Okay. And you don't need any documents like CET, right? Like for online application when we fill the CET form.
Yeah, you don't require any documents. Yeah, you have to keep it ready when you're filling. After your results are declared, you're filling up the optional form. That time you have to scan and upload the documents. Not now. But keep all these documents ready till then.
Yeah, okay. Thank
you. Okay. Any more queries?
Performa O, ma'am, we will get it from the website.
I will put it on the group. Whenever you have to fill, it's there on the website. So you just have to take a print of that page and fill it up.
And scan it. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Ma'am,
I'm not a part of the WhatsApp group.
So you send me, I'll send you the link. Just send me that I want to join the WhatsApp group. I'll send you the link.
Okay, sure, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, anything else? Okay, so with please remain in check all the WhatsApp groups. We are planning to have on next Friday ELCT session. Okay, because depending on our availability, so there are other teachers. Of course, I'll be there to answer your queries. So till then, if you have any queries, you can ask. But the two teachers from our college, they'll be doing English ELCT. Orientation. So we will be going in depth now. Okay. After that, next week, again, I'll come up with mental ability session and the teacher aptitude session later. So you can imagine we will be conducting sessions of 2 hours again for ELCT, only exclusively ELCT, exclusively mental ability, exclusively for teacher aptitude. And GK, I have given you idea what you can start reading up. Okay, so start preparing for your BA because the exam you can expect in next 2 months' time. So start preparing. You know, some time you devote for your BA preparation, the preparation for the CET and the ELCT exam. Okay.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
One minute. I'm born in Mumbai and I want to join the if you want to join the WhatsApp group, send me my number is there. This is my number. One minute. Send me a message, WhatsApp message. I'll add you to the group. I'll send you the link for the group. You can join the group.
Ma'am, thank you so much. It was really a very superb lecture on the BEd admission process as well as the entire criteria for it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, thank you so much for this help. It is so generous a help that you're giving to each one of us. God bless. Thank you.
Ma'am, Hiteshi is asking me, I was born in Mumbai and to apply for Gujarat, do I need provide? Yeah. I have told you, besides the performa, you will need a domicile. I just showed you also what is written. So let us not take any chance. Even if for minority quota, if you're applying for Christian minority, Gujarati minority, Muslim minority, please remember you will need performa, which is easily available. But domicile, you may need. Some college may not give you admission on that ground. So please apply for domicile. Nowadays, you get domicile in 15 days' time. If you go to the Tahsildar's office or just go online on Aple Sarkar, you will get domicile. So you need to produce some electricity or where you stay, those bills. Nowadays, domicile is needed. Not for those who are applying in the open category. If you have a birth certificate, that is fine. If you're born in Maharashtra, that's it. Okay? Yeah, I've sent you my number. Please send me messages. Your name and number. I'll send you the link to join the WhatsApp group. Okay? Should I stop here? It was nice interacting with you. Please look forward to all our sessions.
Ma'am, for MA, ma'am, for MA in Hindi, we have to give CET compulsory or we can directly take admission.
Who told you can directly take admission? MA in Hindi?
Yes.
You want to do MA in Hindi?
Yes.
That you go to university and apply.
Okay, no, but someone is, I asked someone, then say said ki you have to give CET for that.
For MA and all, there is no CET.
Okay.
CET is for BEd.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Okay, so no more questions, I'll stop.
Ma'am?
Hmm?
Hello?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah. Miss, I had written the message that I am 12th pass and I want to go for that BEd and or BA BEd. So that BA BEd is applying from the next year, right? So this year I should do, and I'm from commerce, so I should do BEd from commerce or arts.
1 minute. How can you're a 12th standard pass? How can you do BEd? You're a commerce student, no? I would advise you, if you can change the faculty, go for arts. You go for BA rather than commerce. Okay, go for BA English literature, Hindi or Marathi or history or geography. I would advise you that. Do BA.
Okay, so after the when the admission process began,
I should take admission. Courses would be go for BA. Why did you not take admission? The link was open for 4 years integrated, but now this year there are BA is offered only at Kolhapur University, not in Mumbai.
Okay, in Mumbai, when will it be available?
Next year, most probably. Next year.
So, if I this year I take admission in BA, then I take then after. Then
you are not
take,
clear. You cannot do BA without a graduation degree.
No, I'm asking that if I take a BA like now in the admission process, when start?
Go ahead. Do your FYBA. Well, no, then BA.
I do BA, then next year when BA course comes in Mumbai, then I can apply for that.
Apply for it, yeah.
Okay.
Now also check, there is this, admissions are going on. You can check the 4 years integrated course. Just check, you will get good idea from that. The link is available on mahacet.org.
Ma'am,
link is
I have a question. So ma'am, when will the courses start, BA courses?
I just told you that the last year's report started from March. So most probably October, November, you can expect. October or November.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Most probably it would go till November. Anything else? The website link is mahacet.org. Keep checking this link. Website. Okay. Hello. No more questions. Stop here. Please, again, I'll tell you, please, we are going to do series of this work sessions. And those would be in depth about mental ability, teacher aptitude, ELCT. Please attend those sessions also. Okay, fine. With this, I think I'll stop here. Okay, I'll end the meeting.
Thank you, ma'am.